All right, we are moving to adrenaline, or we say adrenal. We call it the glands of emergency. Now, where are these located? Location, as always, these are located on the top of kidneys. And it has two parts. The external one is cortex. It has two parts. The external one, it is known as cortex. And the inner one, or we can say internal one, that is called medulla. Right? Cortex जो होता है इसको सराउंड करता है एक फाइब्रस टिश्यू एंड वी कॉल इट कैप्स्यूल. सो एम राइटिंग हियर इट इज सराउंडेड बाय कैप्स्यूल. बोथ दिस कॉर्टेक्स एज वेल एज द मेडुला दे हैव डिफरेंट एम्ब्रियोनिक ओरिजिन सो देयर फंक्शंस आर डिफरेंट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम मूविंग टू एड्रीनल कॉर्टेक्स. When we are talking about this, iska origin jo hota hai, it is from the mesoderm. Mesoderm, germ layer. So this one is originated from the mesoderm germ layer. And basically, the structure is divided into three zones. And in these three zones, they are basically, the common ones are the cells of zona fasciculate and reticulate. I'm writing down the three zones in which the structure is divided. One is zona glomerulosa, this lies just below the capsule, and normally it constitutes about 15% of the gland. Okay, and its main purpose is to secrete mineralo corticoids. We will be doing two types of corticoids, mineralocorticoids and sex corticoids. The mineralocorticoids are responsible for affecting the mineral reabsorption. That means these affect mineral reabsorption, or we say mineral homeostasis. तो ये mineral के लिए important होता है. Alright, then the second part is zona reticularis. Zona reticularis. This zona reticularis, it constitutes about 7% of the gland. Right? And the cells are arranged in branching cords. And the cells here, they secrete gonadocorticoids. Androgens. Alright. Androgens, basically they have their masculine effect. Clear? These two cells contain ascorbic acid. That is vitamin C. And all the hormones of adrenal cortex, they are synthesized from cholesterol. So we call them corticoids. Means the hormones of adrenal cortex. Now, the third one is glucocorticoids. This was the second one, glucocorticoids, and that's secreted from zona fasciculata. Zona fasciculata. These are basically constituting about 50% of the gland. सबसे मेजर होता है. सेल्स आर अरेंज्ड बेसिकली इन लॉन्ग स्ट्रेट कॉलम्स एंड द सेल सिक्रीट ग्लूको कॉर्टिकॉइड्स. अब ग्लूकोज नाम लिया है हमने यहाँ पे, तो ये क्या करेगा, ग्लूकोज होम्योस्टेसिस, दैट इज रीअब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ ग्लूकोज इन द किडनीज व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड. सो ऑल द थ्री दीज आर कॉर्टिकॉइड्स एज आई सेड, हॉर्मोन्स ऑफ एड्रीनल कॉर्टेक्स एंड दे आर सिक्रीटेड सेपरेटली फ्रॉम ऑल द थ्री जोन्स एंड एज पर देयर एक्शन. नाउ व्हाट इज देयर एक्शन ऑन द बॉडी. Their action includes, first of all, if we are talking about mineralocorticoids, as we have discussed, first of all, it has to maintain the mineral homeostasis. So it is the principle of mineralocorticoid in humans that it will function to regulate the sodium content of body. It is always secreted when the sodium content is low. And what happens then? Then it acts on kidneys, cause more sodium to return, to be returned to the blood. In return, it allows more potassium to be excreted, because ions ko to balance karna hai na. So if sodium is reabsorbed or returned back to the blood, what is excreted then? Potassium. And what have we done? Sodium is returned back to blood. So when the sodium concentration in blood increases, now water moves in, water will follow it, right? And this process occurs because of osmosis. And what will happen to the blood volume? The blood volume also increase. And it is the effect of aldosterone, how to increase the sodium and water level in blood. Clear? That's why an emergency gland, that it equally affects the concentration of maintenance of sodium and water level in blood effectively. Moving to glucocorticoids. Corticoids yaad rakhna hai, mineralo hue, gluco hue, gonado hue, it all depends. Okay, glucocorticoids, as the name suggests, what do they do? They help in glucose metabolism. And what is included in glucose metabolism? Carbohydrates. So they affect the metabolism of proteins, carbohydrates, proteins too, along with carbohydrates, along with fats. ठीक है, ये भी इसके साथ metabolize हो जाती हैं. Normally, there are three types of cortisols which work. But cortisol is the most abundant one, right? What happens? Cortisol क्या करता है? In glucocorticoids, see, cortisol, it stimulates the degradation stimulates the degradation of proteins within cells and amino acids in blood. अब ब्लड के अंदर अमीनो एसिड्स की डिग्रेडेशन होगी. व्हाट विल हैपन? राइज इन अमीनो एसिड्स इन द ब्लड. सो थर्ड इफेक्ट क्या होगा? ब्रेक डाउन ऑफ फैट्स. राइट, वेयर इज फैट लोकेटेड? इन द एडिपोस टिश्यू. तो ब्लड में क्या रिलीज करेगा? Fatty acids in blood. Now let's check. क्या क्या rise हो गया blood में? Amino acid rise in the blood. Fatty acid rise in the blood. Right? तो इसका क्या हो जाता है? It has an anti-insulin effect. मतलब ये anti-inflammatory होता है. ये mast cells का number reduce करता है. Then secretion of histamine release करता है. Immunosuppressive होता है. This cortisol, it also behaves as anti-inflammatory. In action. Okay? How is it anti-inflammatory? Because the activities, kiski phagocytic activities of WBCs? Phagocytic activities of WBCs thus suppress the reaction and it becomes inflammatory in action because it does not release the secretion of histamine. Histamine kya hota hai? Histamine hota hai hamari body mein mast cells hoti hain. Let me explain you what is it. Our body has mast cells. It secretes serotonin and histamine whenever we encounter any kind of antigenic property to an allergic reaction. Then these mast cells secrete serotonin and histamine. All right. So this particular one, it causes an anti-inflammatory reaction, means it retards the phagocytic activities of WBCs, suppress the inflammation reaction, it reduces the number of mast cells, reducing the secretion of histamine. That is why it is also called that it shows an anti-inflammatory effect and it is immunosuppressive in nature. Understood? Next we move to gonadocorticoids. Gonadocorticoids, we also call them sex corticoids. These gonadocorticoids basically are always in large quantities in males than females. This is on the basis of production. These male sex hormones are androgens, which are important in the development of male fetus. Although the genetic sex is determined by the chromosomes in the fertilized egg, we know that a male fetus develops normal male characteristics only if the fetal gonads and adrenal glands produce sufficient quantities of androgen. So this is the androgen which detects. Therefore, androgen stimulation, basically it involves the stimulation of development of male secondary sexual characteristics. वो क्या होते हैं, वी नो दैट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ बॉडी पैटर्न, हेयर एंड अदरवाइज वॉस वॉइस, वो तो सब बाद में आता है, बट मेनली तो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ बॉडी हेयर एंड सर्टेन अदर पैटर्न्स जो नॉर्मली कैटेगराइज हो जाते हैं, उसको एंड्रोजन्स ज़्यादा फेवर करते हैं. फीमेल सेक्स डेवलपमेंट एंड द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दिस एड्रीनल कॉर्टेक्स लाइक एस्ट्रोजन, इट मेंटेन्स द फीमेल सेकेंडरी सेक्शुअल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, बट दैट इज लिटिल लेस कंपेयर टू द मेल वंस. सो दीज गोनेडोकॉर्टिकॉइड्स दे एक्ट ऑन द सेल्स ऑफ गोनैड्स. Okay, which gonads? Testes and ovaries. And what do? They secrete androgen and estrogen. It maintains the male secondary sexual characteristics. And this one maintains the female secondary sexual characteristics. All right, let me discuss a little disease, like a disorder. Disease नहीं बोलेंगे, disorder बोलेंगे. Disorder किसका? Adrenal cortex का. क्या disorder है? First one is Addison's disease. This is because of the deficiency of mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids, right? Why does it happen? What happens basically when mineralo and gluco are working? उनके अंदर क्या होता है? उनके अंदर cells काम करती हैं, right? Anti-inflammatory reaction होता है, sodium water balance increase होता है. If this disorder is happening because of mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids, it means certain cells, they got dysfunctional or non-functional, and because of the destruction of adrenal cortex, like tuberculosis disease, over there destruction of adrenal cortex happens in TB, tuberculosis, destruction of adrenal cortex. Main area तो यही है ना, adrenal cortex, from where all the problem arises. Because adrenal cortex is only secreting mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids. If by the chance adrenal cortex cells undergo destruction, what will happen? It can lead to a disease like tuberculosis. Ultimately, what will be the symptoms? Symptoms here would be low BP, then low plasma sodium, high potassium, increased urinary sodium ions, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, right, and pigmentation of skin. Pigmentation कैसी होती है इसमें? Bronze like a metal bronze color. तो हम इसको bronze like बोल देते हैं, ठीक है? And not to forget, water तो automatically sodium के साथ ही होता है. So dehydration, which is quite common. Then second is Cushing syndrome. Cushing syndrome caused by excess of cortisol. Excess of cortisol. And अगर excess of cells हो जाते हैं, they forget their stop back arrangement. तो वो क्या करते हैं? These excess of cells they keep on piling up at one place and they cause a tumor. Tumor of adrenal cortex. तो इसमें क्या होगा? इसमें high BP हो जाएगा, right? And automatically when it is high BP, then there would be appearance of various other sugar like symptoms in the urine. Sugar rise in urine, rise in plasma sodium, ions increase, fall in plasma potassium ions, and then automatically ये pelvic and pectoral girdle के muscles को भी affect करता है, right? तो obesity, being obese and wasting of muscles, it occurs. Clear? Then is gynecomastia, the third one. Gynecomastia. Now, gynae. Gynae is the word which is connected to specially females. है ना? तो अगर हम गाइनी वर्ड रीड कर रहे हैं, इट मीन्स सर्टेन फीमेल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर मोर एनलार्ज्ड. सो हियर नॉर्मली डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एनलार्ज्ड मैमरी ग्लैंड्स विच टेक प्लेस इन द मेल्स. एंड्रोजन ज़्यादा इफेक्टिव किस में होते हैं? मेल्स में. एंड व्हाट डू दे कंट्रोल? मेल सेकेंडरी सेक्सुअल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, राइट? सो दिस इज अ डिसऑर्डर. देन व्हाट विल हैपन? दिस सेज दैट देयर इज एक्सेसिव सेक्रेशन ऑफ फीमेल सेक्स हॉर्मोन्स इन मेल्स विच विल लीड टू गायनेकोमेस्टिया. दैट मीन्स एक्सेसिव सेक्रेशन ऑफ फीमेल sex hormone, which one is it? Estrogen in males compared to androgens. Ultimately, decreased testosterone level leads to gynecomastia. Clear? Moving to adrenal medulla. When we are talking about the hormones of adrenal medulla, first of all, from where do they have their origin? That is from the neuroectoderm of the embryo. नहीं याद रहेगा तो इतना याद रखना, देर आर थ्री जंगलियस. एंडो, मीजो, एक्टो. ओके, एंडो इज द इनर वन, मीजो इज द सेंट्रल वन, एंड एक्टो इज द आउटर वन. ऑल राइट. सो दिस वन इज न्यूरो एक्टो, मीन्स फ्रॉम द आउटर साइड विच इज कनेक्टेड towards the neural side, neuroectoderm of the embryo. It consists of rounded group of relatively large granular cells. So what is it made up of? What the structure enclosed of? Structure shows granulated rounded group of cells. Okay, being granulated, normally they have acquired a glandular function now. Granulated होते हैं, इकट्ठे होते हैं, group में होते हैं. They perform a glandular function for being together. All right. So, which hormones do they secrete? Hormones secreted here are norepinephrine, and epinephrine. Okay, norepinephrine is also known as noradrenaline. What do we call it? Noradrenaline. Epinephrine, adrenaline. Here, adrenaline. Clear? What this one does? It regulates BP. Regulates blood pressure under normal conditions. Cause constriction of blood vessels of the body. If the blood vessels will constrict, what will happen? Obviously, the heart activity, the dilation of pupil will take place. Everything will increase. Sort of constriction of a blood vessel, narrowing of a blood vessel will automatically lead to increased blood flow. All right, from a narrow opening, this will lead to increased activity of heart, then secondly we can say inhibition of gastrointestinal tract. Dilation of pupil of eye and so forth. Okay, moving to this epinephrine. Epinephrine is mainly secreted at the time of emergency. Secreted at the time of emergency. Okay, what kind of emergency are we talking about? We say effects little bit are different compared to the non-epinephrine one. What are this? First of all, epinephrine jo hota hai na, iski greater effect hoti hai cardiac ke upar. Means iska influence cardiac ke upar zyada hota hai. Aur ye stronger constriction karta hai blood vessels ka. Bahut strong constriction hota hai iska blood vessels ka compared to this norepinephrine. So it can show a great metabolic effect. First is it has greater effect on cardiac. Ek comparison point hai. Second is much more constriction of blood vessels. Causes much more constriction or strong constriction of blood vessels. And automatically, as a result of it, it shows a great metabolic effect. ठीक है इसका मेटाबॉलिक इफेक्ट थोड़ा ज़्यादा होता है बट बोथ एड्रेनालिन एंड नॉरएड्रेनालिन एक्ट ऑन द सेल्स ऑफ स्केलेटल कार्डियक एंड स्मूथ मसल्स बिकॉज देयर रोल इज टुगेदर एंड वी कॉल इट द ग्लैंड्स ऑफ एमरजेंसी सिंस दे प्ले अ रोल टुगेदर दैट्स व्हाई दे एक्ट टुगेदर फाइन टारगेट सेल्स देयर टारगेट सेल्स आर skeletal, then we say the other one, second one is cardiac, and the third one is smooth muscles. Smooth muscles of the body, that means blood vessels also. It includes blood vessels as well, fat cells as well. They act together, both of them they act together. Non-adrenaline, it acts a little slow compared to the adrenaline as its mode of action is quite active. Means adrenaline has a greater effect compared to non-adrenaline. But yes, together they act as the glands of emergency. Right. Moving to the next one, which is known as hypothalamus. What do we know about hypothalamus? Hypothalamus, from where does it arise? Its origin is from the ectoderm of embryo. Have you heard hypothalamus, pituitary gland, together they work, and pituitary is the master endocrine gland and hypothalamus is the supermaster endocrine gland. It's all because it controls all the releasing hormones. Its location is below the thalamus. If we do not use the word below, we can also write inferior to thalamus also. What it does, its connection is directly between the nervous and the endocrine system. So it connects nervous and endocrine system together. Hypothalamus is basically connected to anterior lobe of pituitary. Hena, it is connected to anterior lobe of pituitary. But there is a vein, usko hum bolte hain hypophyseal. Portal vein, HYPOPHYSIAL, hypophyseal portal vein connects hypothalamus to anterior lobe of pituitary. Hypothalamus ko supreme commander bolte hain. Supreme commander. Or supermaster gland of endocrine secretions. Why? Because it synthesizes at least 9 different hormones. Which all hormones? 9 different hormones are secreted. Number 1, adrenocorticotrophic releasing hormone. Okay. Corticotrophic releasing hormone. Let's write down the short forms of them. ARH. The first one is ARH. Adrenocorticotrophic releasing hormone. Writing the short forms of all. ARH. When we have to discuss, we will do all the full forms there. Then, this basically stimulates the anterior lobe of pituitary to release or to secrete its adrenocorticotrophic hormone. So, this adrenocorticotrophic releasing hormone secretes what? ACTH. That means adrenocorticotrophic hormone. Then, number 2, thyrotrophin releasing hormone. What it stimulates? It secretes TSH. What is the full form? Thyroid stimulating hormone. Third is growth hormone releasing hormone. What it releases? Growth hormone. Fine. Number 4. GnRH. Isko bolte hain gonadotrophin releasing hormone. It secretes FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, and LH, luteinizing hormone. Then is PRH, prolactin releasing hormone. It releases prolactin only. Fine. Then is MSH releasing hormone, melanocyte releasing hormone. It secretes MSH. Okay, melanocyte releasing hormone secretes MSH. Same way is its inhibitory. So, this is how these are the mainly cells which are secreted. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone, thyrotropic releasing hormone, growth hormone. Growth ka ek inhibitory hoga because there are people those who are showing excessive gigantism and dwarfism over there, the growth, whenever the growth shows PD, that is gigantism is there, then its growth inhibitory hormone is also active. Then is gonadotropin releasing hormone, prolactin hormone releasing hormone. Then is iska bhi inhibitory aata hai. That means prolactin releasing inhibitory hormone, okay, which inhibits the synthesis of prolactin in the body. Then is melanocyte secretory hormone, and iska bhi ek inhibitory hota hai, melanocyte inhibitory hormone. So in total these are 9, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, iska 7, 8 and 9. These are the 9 hormones which are secreted or released by the hypothalamus, and they act on the body. Clear?